got beef. Who's smashing who?
Smashing.
This is hip hop news.
Right now.
Gossip.
Yeah.
411.
Yeah. And all the latest tabloid bullshit.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Let's go.
I got that juice. New AP. She got that juice.
I got your juicy entertainment news for Wednesday. Facebook is planning to change its company name next week. Mark Zuckerberg has plans to turn his social media space into a metaverse. What exactly is a metaverse? Well, it's described as a set of virtual spaces where you can create and explore with other people who aren't in the same physical space as you. And this new space will allow users to hang out with friends, work, play, learn, shop, create, and more. So in other words, you just don't need to be around people anymore, physically. The rebrand will likely position Facebook, the app, as one of the many products under a parent company that will be overseeing their groups like Instagram, WhatsApp, and others. And along with the rebrand comes, of course, a new name, which is being kept very tight under wraps. Zuckerberg is expected to discuss the change during next week's Facebook conference on October 28th, and we just might see a name change. Dr. Dre was reportedly handed his divorce papers while he was attending his grandmother's funeral. This is so, so classless. Sources say that he was handed the documents as he stood by his grandmother's casket. He reacted angrily, obviously, and refused to take the documents, and then the server supposedly placed the papers near the gravesite. Now, his ex, Nicole Young, is denying those reports, saying that he was actually served the papers in the parking lot after the funeral. Now, these documents relate to further payments for her legal fees, which Dre has already paid over $300,000 for, and a judge ordered him to pay a total of $1.55 million for her legal fees. Now, Dre contested this order when it was signed back in September, and he claimed that he's already paid the full fee. The couple, of course, have been at each other's throats since filing for divorce last June. Young listed irreconcilable differences as the initial reason for the divorce, but then later accused Dre of abuse. He replied to those accusations and saying that that was part of an elaborate scam to extort money from him. He filed documents where he denied any wrongdoing and claimed that Nicole didn't bring up the allegations of abuse until after seeing that the prenup wouldn't give her half of his money. While doing the rounds promoting the new ABC series, Queens, Eve, Brandy, and Notori Naughton were on The Breakfast Club yesterday morning. And Notori said that there were scenes in the new series, Queens, that were very similar to what she actually experienced in real life when she was part of the R&B group 3LW in 2000. For example, she said they actually did a fake MTV Cribs. You know, 3LW was real hot. She said they had to pretend. She said she did not have a car. She did not have a house. She didn't have anything. So they rented this big mansion, and they taped MTV Cribs. And then when the taping was over, they had to clean the house by 7 o'clock to give it back to the owner. Wow. Now, you know, a few months ago, MTV brought back the classic show Cribs, an updated version. You get to see Rick Ross, Martha Stewart, all kinds of others, Snoop Dogg. And since the new version has come out, a lot of artists came forward to say that the original Cribs back in the day, many of the homes shown didn't belong to them, and the cars were just rented for the day. 50 was caught up in that too. Remember that extravagant collection of cars that he showed off? Well, apparently that was somebody's collection and was not his. And that's your juicy entertainment news for Wednesday. Lock it in again tomorrow for more of the juice right here on the all-new Kiss 96. 3LW, P. Diddy, Loon right now, taking you back.